We fight quite a few fires in this town through the year. It's not a majority of our calls, but we do have enough of them. I mean, we're a pretty busy department. We run over 400 calls a year.
We have had restaurant fires in the past, but this was a different attack. You're talking about a two-floor building, which is much resembles a house because that's what it was originally built at, with multiple extensions on top of that. So now you're fighting it from the same almost as a house would be, but you have this additional area as well. As we pulled up, some smoke was coming out of the eaves, and there was smoke conditions inside.
The initial crew, they pulled walls, they started to pull the ceiling above the bar, they had a large volume of fire.
There was fire in the walls already. And with a balloon frame construction, there's no barrier between each floor, so it'll just chase up. And that chased up to the second floor, and then it caught into the roof. And then with the amount of work that's been done on, you know, there's a lot of work done on that property over the years, there was voids and issues. And then you had the new portion that they just added on, I guess it was about a year ago, where it chased across there as well.
First line came in right away, five-man crew, they started to do their work, and it was just too far gone.
The conditions continued to decay, and we realized that we needed additional manpower and resources to the scene. That's when we activated the Union County Mutual Aid System. Decided that we needed to back out and reassess and go into this defensive mode. When you go into a defensive mode, you use larger diameter hoses. You put your truck companies into operation so that you can flow it a lot of water, you know, in a little bit of time.
And a fire's never good. You have to worry about the men and the people inside first. Life hazard is automatically first. A building's a building, it can be rebuilt. You can't rebuild a life.
It's not an easy thing to do, because really what you're doing is writing the building off.
We had four ladders going for probably about 6 hours before it was completely knocked down.
At one point, we were probably flowing between 4,000 and 6,000 gallons a minute. Just really surrounded and drowned it.
It's a long process, and especially with when we're dealing with cold weather as well, rotating in and out manpower as much as we can to keep everybody warm.
It was a big incident. It's probably the most fire we've had since the late 90s.
My wife, myself, and a captain and his girlfriend ate dinner there that evening. Nothing out of the ordinary. It's just a coincidence. It happens.
It was a popular place, actually. It was probably their best location. The town's going to do everything they can to help them get back and rebuilt.
As far as a total loss like that, it's been a real long time since we had a total loss of a structure. It hurts a little, but we'll move on.
It's a shame that it happened, but hopefully they and they said they're going to rebuild, which is really nice. And, hope it comes to stature in the community again. That's what you hope for.